Hello folks, today I come back with a bit of a shorter video, and in this one I'm going to build something that has been suggested to me in the past, and it's all the way back from the tiger video where I built a tiger 2. Someone suggested me to build a little bit of a red tank, if I can even call a tank that is. In question is the Panzerbefehlswagen. In other words, it's a vehicle that's based off the Panzer 1, and it is a command APC, so it's not something that has a whole lot of armor. It also has like literally only a single machine gun for its firepower, but it's a tiny boy. It's something that's pretty far away from what I usually build. It's World War II era, mostly interwar era, honestly, because it's just so incredibly light. It's like nothing compared to some of the things we see later in the war, but this right here is just going to be a little bit of a fun experiment, and I'm going to see what I manage to pull off with this one. I'm going to try to make it look as close to the actual thing as possible, have the speed match up the real thing, have the armor mostly match up the real thing, and see how it goes. And for this thing's stats and so on, all that you have to worry about is it can go up to 40 kilometers an hour, so it's pretty decently fast. It has a single machine gun for its firepower, like it literally has nothing else, and at most it has 15 millimeters of armor. So yeah, like this thing is it's just not going to be very, very good. I'm going to try what I could with it. Just getting the barrel shape that this thing is going to have, it's really not going to be that big. Using some pistons over here, you can see, just to get the shape I want out of these wheels. Alongside some pretty basic suspension over there, nothing crazy, just like a bunch of the common suspension blocks just lined up. And as I was working on the front plate that this thing is going to have, I noticed that like even these heavy blocks, they would be just way too much ammo for the actual thing, so I'm just setting down with like these common blocks, maybe some shoots on top of them, but that's it. And I began working on just like the overall shape of the vehicle. As you can see, it's just like a solid turret that is in place, no movement whatsoever. Pretty easy to make and quite nice looking. Got the little shitter machine gun, just like it can move around and stuff and can definitely fire, so yeah, that's a thing. It drives around quite nicely, as you can see. That's really mostly the shape and everything that I want in it. It's not a hard, difficult to build vehicle by any means, it's just this little nice thing, this little red. Was deployed mostly by the Italian army, North Africa and such, at least from what I read. And I do impress myself at my capability to bring even this little shitter vehicle into the fucking complexity counter. Just making the armor a bit shiny, just like putting these 1x2 shields over here. And the only single requirement I want out of this thing is for it to be able to tank a few machine gun shots, just like a few of these bullets. That is literally the only thing I want this vehicle to do. And as you can see, it does that decently well, like it's not breaking apart immediately, as this test suggests. So it's efficient. Placing this here just because. And the other tanks, it's supposed to be like the ammo gun, but I'm gonna guess like to just like a bunch of machine gun bombs. Job done. And as you may see, I got a few textures all over the place. And I think that overall, this thing's shape, the colors, all of it aligns pretty well. The gun moves around, it's functional, you got a working camera in here. I'd say that this is a pretty, very nice looking boy. It's over here. As far as armor goes, this thing only has a bunch of 1x2 shields all over the place and a few smaller blocks, but like overall, like right over here, it's really just like a bunch of shields all over the place, including this right here. And if you are paying a bit of attention on some of the previous steps, you noticed that this thing was a wedge, and I decided to instead have a few hinges doing the job. And the reason for that is, using hinges I can pull up shields on top of this thing, because I really, really wanted this vehicle to have an armor capable of stopping one thing and one thing only, and that is bullets. And as you may see, that was an entire set of bullets from that minigun over there. It's an pretty, you know, average distance for combat, and it struggles a little bit. Like, of course there are pierced pieces that are torn off, but as you can see, like, it mostly holds itself together. That is the entire bit about this thing. And again, it's pretty effective armor against bullets, so it's going to be able to stop at least that. Like, even at close up range, if you have a smart cannon, it's not really going to go through this thing. And there you have it. This is just a bit of a shorter video. It's only going to be hitting the 6-minute threshold in just like a few seconds, which is pretty small for me. And on a side note, this tank was pretty fun to build. I'm going to see if I leave it in the description for you guys to get it. Like, just like this little red thing. And as an announcement for anyone that doesn't already know, I have made a Discord server, and I have already announced it in the last video, but I'm just going to keep yoinking this out constantly. And you guys can join, there's a lot of fun stuff that's going on over there. It's active pretty much every single day, and just like people discussing techs and so on and so forth. And many of the things that I will make videos in the future from now on, I'm going to put down there, and it's just free time. So maybe do hop on, maybe, perhaps, possibly. With that said, I'm going to let it go for now, chat, and it's been a pleasure. This has been Osiris. I see you guys later.